What's up? It's Mushu Samurai Stories, and today I'm talking about Ishikawa Goemon, a famous ninja sometimes referred to as the Japanese Robin Hood, although radically different than the most known version of Robin Hood. Explicit warning on this one, guys, it's going to get pretty graphic, but let's get into it. Ishikawa Goemon's life is told in many different ways, but most believe that he was born in the year 1558 to a samurai family in the Iga province. It's said at the age of 15, men from the Ashikaga province broke into their home and killed both of his parents right in front of him. He then swore revenge and began training in the arts of ninjutsu under Momochi Sendayu, a leader of the Iga ninjas. But a few years into this, Sendayu kicks him out because he apparently had a relationship with one of his mistresses. And also, on his way out, he stole a prize katana. A little rascal. Another telling is that he was trained by the samurai and ninja whose name translates to 100 Earths, which is a pretty badass name, I gotta say. In that version, Goemon escaped after having sex with 100 Earths' wife and also killing a concubine. But after he breaks from the Iga ninjas is when his tales as a great thief begins. In one tale, he snuck into the highly defended Osaka castle to steal the treasured golden skull. Another tale says he attempted to assassinate Oda Nobunaga, the first unifier of Japan. But in his travels, he gained a following of other thieves and bandits fed up with the inequality of wealth at the time. And together they went around during the day posing as merchants to find a way into the rich feudal lords' castles. Then at night they would sneak in and steal gold and treasures from their houses. Afterwards, similarly to Robin Hood, he would distribute his wealth among the less fortunate and the lower class, supposedly. But this is where it differs from any Robin Hood tale. The new leader Toyotomi Hideyoshi had been conducting raids on surrounding villages, and in doing so, Ishikawa Goemon's wife was murdered in one of the raids. So Goemon sneaks into Fushimi Castle, the home of Hideyoshi, to kill him. But as fate would have it, on his way in, Goemon bumped a bell off of a shelf, alerting the guards and being captured immediately. This is when Lord Hideyoshi famously rounded up Goemon, his family, and other bandits to be boiled alive publicly. They threw Goemon in the boiling pot with his own son, screaming in agony and somehow holding his son above his head to save him from the pain. One version says he eventually succumbed to the burns and him and his son were boiled alive. But one very interesting version says Goemon held his son up long enough for an onlooker to swoop in and run off with his son, which I hope at least his son lived. Although this incredibly graphic ending, Ishikawa Goemon's life has been portrayed in many books, movies, kabuki plays, video games, animes, and even a puppet show. Most of these stories sensationalizing his thieving and giving back to the poor. But other media is not as flattering. A type of fire-heated baths were named Goemon Boro, or Goemon Bath. Because who doesn't want to think about being boiled alive while you're in the bathtub? A Japanese spaghetti restaurant named Yomenya Goemon uses Goemon as its symbol because of the way they boil their noodles. I mean, come on. Also, though, a professional wrestler, now retired, went by the name Goemon all across Japan. One of Konami's first computer games was based on Ishikawa Goemon named Mr. Goemon, which went on to become a huge series of games that got its own TV show. In the game Samurai Warriors, he is known as the King of Thieves, and he also appears in games like Persona 5 and Shogun Warriors as well. There was one movie made that translates to Goemon Will Never Die, where he escapes being boiled alive and attempts to kill Hideyoshi with the help of the famous ninja Hattori Hanzo. Which sounds like a pretty awesome movie. I mean, Bruce Willis status there. Now, aside from naming a spaghetti place, a bathtub, and even a type of boiled shrimp after him, they also built a shrine at the site of his death named Mizunase Jingu Shrine in the Osaka Prefecture, where his remains are believed to be. The last thing I want to mention is this guy even had a song written about him in the 70s, and although I couldn't find that exact song by Ichi Otake, it was actually a cover that used the instrumentation of a much more famous song called Nagisa no Sinbad by Pink Lady, a Japanese female duo, and it is a great song. I'm going to play it here. So enjoy the tunes. I'll link the song below. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more and slice that like button like I slice these rice cakes.
かかる